Hello everyone, in this video, we're going to solve this sixth degree equation. So first, we're going to factor this part. So then we have x plus 1, then x plus 2. Then factor the next one. That's x minus 3, then x minus 4. We cannot factor the next one. So then we just write down the rest of the part. Now let's see what's next. So next, we are going to reorganize these four factors. So we are going to do this. Combine the first factor with the third factor, so x minus 3. Then combine the second factor with the fourth factor. The reason you will see in the next step. Then just the rest of the equation. So next, we are going to expand this product. So here we have x squared minus 2x minus 3. Then for the second one, expand this part. So then we have x squared minus 2x minus 8, then the rest of the equation. So then you notice, so there's something they have in common for these three factors. X squared minus 2x, same here. So that's why we're going to set up a new variable, y. Then what's y? So we're going to let the y equals x minus 1 squared. Then what's x minus 1 squared? Just x squared minus 2x plus 1. So next step, we're going to use a y, rewrite the equation. So write the equation in terms of y. So then here we have. Okay, so let's see the first factor, x squared minus 2x plus 1, so that will be y. Then minus 1 minus 3, so that will be minus 4. Same thing for the second one, x squared minus 2x plus 1, so that will be y. Then minus 1 minus 8, that's minus 9. Then same thing for the last one. So here will be y minus 2 here, then plus 24 equals 0. So now you see, so we already changed the original sixth degree equation. Now we have a cubic equation. Okay, so then let's expand the factor. So then and simplify. Then we have this one. X to the third, then minus 15y squared plus 62y minus 48. Then equals 0. So then for this equation, we can easily tell y equal 1 is a solution of the equation. So then for this equation, we can write as a y minus 1 as a y squared minus 14y plus 48 equals 0. So how to get from here to here? Just use long division. Because y minus 1 is a factor, so use long division or factoring we got here. Then we can continue to factor this part. That's just a y minus 1. Here is a y minus 6, y minus 8. Then for this equation, there are three solutions. The first solution, y equals 1. Okay, so let's solve it, okay? So the first solution, y equals 1. So we want to solve for x. Because y equals x minus 1 squared. So that's why equivalent to y minus 1 squared equal 1. Then solve this equation. Both sides take a square root with a right hand side with positive negative sign, then both sides plus 1. So here we have x equals to 1 plus minus 1. Then here we have the two solutions, 0 and 2. The second solution for y equals 6. Here we have y equals 6. So then here equivalent to x minus 1 squared equals 6. Then solve this equation. Then here we have x equals to 1 plus minus square root 6. Then the third solution for y, that's y equals 8. So then we have x minus 1 squared equals 8. So then we have solution for x is x equals 1 plus minus square root 8. So then we can continue to simplify this radical. So then we have 1 plus minus 2 square root 2. So now we have the six solutions. Okay, so the six solutions for the equation. 0, 2, 1 plus minus square root 6, then 1 plus minus 2 square root 2. Thanks for watching. See you next time.